Kenzie and I began our current river backpacking and canoe loop on March 14th at the Powder Mill Campground. We hiked north for roughly 18 miles along the current river section of the Ozark Trail. This was the first day of what would be a 4-day backpacking and canoe loop bringing us back to the Powder Mill Campground via the current river.
One evening as the sun went down and the jungle fire was burning, down the track came a hobo hiking, and he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away beside the crystal fountains. So come with me, we'll go and see the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright, where the handouts grow on bushes and you sleep out every night, where the boxcars all are empty and the sun shines every day on the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees, the lemonade springs where the bluebird sings in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, all the cops have wooden legs and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth."
This is our home for the night. We're a little bit east of the actual trail. A little confused with the river crossing, but small fires are good fires. Build that little ring. Day two began by backpacking south along Brushy Creek Trail through some Forest Service logging areas. Upon reaching the river, we turned west and joined back up with the current River Ozark Trail section. By now, we'd crossed an unsurmountable number of streams and our feet were terribly blistered, but we persevered and eventually made our way to Round Springs State Park, completing the backpacking section with a 23-mile day.
"And the hens lay soft-boiled eggs. The farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay. Oh, I'm bound to go where there ain't no snow, where the rain don't fall, the wind don't blow, in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, you never change your socks, and the little streams of alcohol come a-trickling down the rocks. The brakemen have to tip their hats, and the railroad bulls are blind. There's a lake of stew and a whiskey too. You can paddle all around them in a big canoe in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, the jails are made of tin, and you can walk right out again as soon as you are in. There ain't no short-handled shovels, no axes, saws, or picks. I'm a-going to stay where you sleep all day, where they hung the Turk that invented work in the Big Rock Candy Mountains." I'll see you all this coming fall in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. I'll see you all this coming fall in the Big Rock Candy Mountains.
On the morning of day three, Wendy's canoe rental met us at Round Spring to drop off our canoe. We paddled all day, occasionally stopping to explore the beautiful Dolomite Bluffs. Along the way, we also saw a few bald eagles, a band of feral horses, a couple river otters, about a million turtles, a few bats, and a lot of salamanders. After 20 miles, we decided to stop at an established campground just past the confluence of Jack's Fork and the current river. Just paddling down the river and we saw like four horses crossing it way up ahead. We're like, what? There's no one on those horses. There's no one riding them. And we tried tried to paddle faster to see them. Really beautiful, but they kind of got into the woods before we could pass them. Then as we were at the spot where we saw them, we looked to our right and felt them and then saw them like running off in the woods. So we don't know, maybe those were wild horses. Maybe they were just running on one property. I don't really know how that works, but it was pretty cool. Also, check out this beautiful bluff. Here's our campsite. Just past Two Rivers campground. Be a nice day. Our second day paddling down the current river and fourth in Ozark National Scenic Riverways began bright and early as the morning dew rose. We finished up the last 7 miles before noon, bringing us back to the Powder Mill Campground and thereby completing the backcountry ONSR route.